Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today is, what is it, August or something? So I thought that I would show you guys some of my favorite summer things that I've been using throughout the entire summer. I cannot believe that it's almost fall. I know a lot of people get really mad when people say that, but I'm just so excited for fall. I am not a summer person, so once September comes, I'm just like the happiest person and I just love fall. But anyways, I'm gonna show you guys some of my favorite summer things. I have beauty stuff, home stuff, like some fashion stuff, but to be honest, I moved into a new house and all I've been wanting to buy is home decor because that's just like where my head's at. So I haven't honestly bought a ton of clothes this summer, so I just thought I would show you whatever my favorite things are, see if you guys like any of it. I hope you do, but let's just jump into it. All right, we will start with beauty stuff because I think that's probably the most exciting. My favorite face mask that I have right now is by Little Barn, and I actually got this at a place that I get my hair cut, and it is really nice. It's in this jar and it's honestly lasted me so long. I've used this like probably like 5 times already and you can hardly tell that I have, but this is supposed to help with blackheads, which is probably like my biggest thing. I don't really have like a ton of breakouts, but around my nose and stuff, I wanted something that got like deep into my pores, and I really like this stuff. It has apricot fruit, or passion fruit and rose, and it's just really awesome. I use a little brush and I paint it on, and I honestly will sometimes just like put it on my nose or like under my mouth. I really like target certain areas and I really like it, and like I said, it's a little expensive, but I'll probably honestly get at least like 20 masks out of this, so it honestly, it all evens out. Okay, so the next thing that I am going to talk about is perfume. I have bought 2 perfumes this summer. The first one I bought was just really light. It wasn't expensive and it was just kind of something that I thought I could like put on kind of as like a body spray instead of a heavy perfume, because I feel like in summer that's kind of what you want. So I went to Anthropologie. I think this was around like $25, and it's a vanilla scent. It's very dirty, so please excuse me, but that is what the bottle looks like. I will try to link as much as I can below, but yes, this one's been very nice this summer. Obviously, you can tell I've used it a ton and I love it. Okay, this is probably the best thing in this entire video, my favorite thing of the entire summer, and it's a perfume. You guys all need to go get it. It is the Glossier perfume. They only have this one scent, I believe. It is amazing. It's super light and one of those perfumes that like I'll spray on in the morning and then I don't really even smell it throughout the day, but I'll get compliments like, oh my gosh, you smell good, or what are you wearing? Are you wearing like a lotion or whatever? It's just like really light and I can't smell it, so I don't really get a headache. Sometimes if I have a really heavy perfume on, I get a headache. So this is amazing. It smells so, so good. I don't think it sells in stores, but just trust me, order it. I think it was around $60, so it's not that bad for a perfume. It's amazing. I love it. Go get it. The next thing that I have is by NYX, and it is Born to Glow. It's a liquid highlight. In the summer, all I really want is to be bronzy and glowy, and I picked this up just because I really wanted a liquid highlighter, but I don't know, I just wanted something that was inexpensive. So I bought this, which I really love this. It is probably like $5 or something like that, but I honestly like put my primer on and I'll put that on my cheekbones and on my nose before I put on like a CC cream or my foundation, and I feel like you can like see it underneath my foundation and it just makes my skin look brighter, healthier, glowier, all those good things for the summertime, and I really like it. I will definitely keep wearing this even into the fall, but it's not super heavy and feels greasy or something, so I really like it. Test it out. I got this at Target. Okay, staying on the brightening train, I talked about this in my spring favorites, but I hadn't used it yet, and I thought I would give you guys a little update. I have used it, and I love it. It is the Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector. So it's not a concealer, but I put it on before my concealer, and I'll put it on the inner corners of my eyes, which is where I get dark. I don't have super dark under eyes, but like the inside corners of my eyes are dark. So I'll put this on before I put on my concealer, and it's just got this like peachy undertone, so it cancels out any of the redness that I, or darkness that I have, and I really, really like this. I think there's 3 different shades, and I got the light to medium. Okay, the next beauty thing that I have is by Laura Mercier, and it is this stick eyeshadow pen. I don't love to wear a ton of eye makeup in the summer. I just feel like it looks heavy, and like I said, I like to keep it kind of light and bright for the summer. So I went ahead and bought this really light eyeshadow pencil, like cream stuff. I don't know, I'm really good at describing things clearly, but it's in the color rose gold. I think for the fall I'll buy another one, but I'll maybe go a couple shades darker just to, you know, switch it up a little bit. But it's super smooth, and I don't know, it's just like really pretty. I love this color, and it's not that different compared to my actual eyelid, but it's just got like a nice shimmer, and I've been really liking this. This is basically this and bronzer is all I've used on my eyelids all summer long, and I really like it. Okay, I feel like in my spring video I mentioned this too, but I hadn't been using it, so I wanted to give you guys a little update and tell you that I love this. It is by Kiehl's. It's the Midnight Recovery Concentrate, and I will put this on before I go to bed. I'll put on like a moisturizer, and then I'll put this on top, and I feel like it's just really made my face smooth, and I just feel very hydrated in the morning when I put that on. I'll sometimes, like on Sundays when I don't wear makeup, I'll put that on even in the morning. You don't have to put it on just for bedtime, but yeah, I really really liked it. I think I will buy the full size. This has lasted me though probably like 2 months, and it was just the travel size. So if you guys want to test it out, just get the travel size. I don't remember how much it was, but it was probably like under $20, I would assume. Okay, this is the last beauty thing that I have, and it's for your hair. This is the Living Proof Dry Volume Blast Spray. In the summertime, my hair goes really flat really quick, and the humidity does not help. So I bought this, and I basically just spray it in my roots when I blow dry my hair. When it's dry, I'll spray it in my roots, and it just helps give me volume and also texture. So like if I need to like fluff my hair up, it'll stay a little longer than it would without this. Yeah, I really really like this stuff. I've bought the travel size before, and I went ahead and bought the full size because I think it will be a permanent thing in my hair care routine. Love it. I got this at Sephora. It is a little pricey, but I definitely think it's worth it. Okay, on to accessories. I'm going to talk about headbands first because I've been loving those. I have this one in my hair right now, which I got from Anthropologie. It's just like an animal print one. And then I also bought this black one from H&M. I definitely like the lighter colors in my hair just because my hair is so dark that sometimes the black gets lost in my hair. But I do really like this one. I want to buy some more colors because I think even going into the fall, I'll love to wear them with like sweaters and stuff. I think they'd be super cute. But yeah, I'll try to link as much of the stuff that I'm showing you guys below in case you guys want to buy them for yourself. Okay, then next I have these sunglasses, which were honestly a happy mistake. I went on a trip to visit some friends, and I forgot my nice sunglasses at home. So I ran into Urban Outfitters. I saw these, and I was like, oh, I don't think I could pull them off, but they were kind of fun, and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna try them. If I don't like them, they weren't very expensive, and I wouldn't mind. So I got these, and I've honestly got more compliments on these than basically anything this summer. So yeah, I really like them. I'll try them on for you guys. They're like very sassy, and I don't know. I get like a mood when I put them on, but I think they're really cute. I think they're around $30 from Urban Outfitters, and I love them. Okay, next are hats. I love hats, so I wanted to buy a few more for the summertime. I got this cute white one from Anthropologie. It is, the brand is W-Y-E-T-H, Wythe or Width or something like that, but I will post it below if I can find it. I think it is so cute, and I have been wearing this all summer long. Next hat is just your classic beach hat. This thing has been submerged in water twice because I keep wearing it on a boat, and it flies off my head, but it is rallied, and it honestly has stayed very nice. I got this one at Urban Outfitters, and I love the style and the shape of it. It's not too big, but it's also kind of like a little bigger than a normal sun hat, so yeah, love it. Okay, so the last accessory that I wanted to talk about was my necklace, which is this big D necklace. It is a dupe from a designer, but I'm not sure even the designer. I got this off Amazon. I think it was around $15 or something. I've wore it all summer, and it hasn't tarnished or turned my skin green or anything like that. It comes in this size and then a smaller size, which I might order my initial for that. I ordered David's for this just because I thought it was kind of cute. But yeah, I've been wearing it all summer. Love it. It's from Amazon. I think it's on Prime even, so you can get it like in 2 days, which is amazing. So yeah, I think it comes in silver as well. So if you're more of a silver person, I think it's really cute. Also for fall, it will look cute with sweaters and stuff. So yeah, I just wanted to share that with you guys. Okay, now on to home stuff. I just grabbed some of the smaller things that I've bought recently to show you guys. I just recently bought these gold trays from West Elm. I saw them and I was obsessed with them. So it comes with like three different sizes of these kind of like rainbow shaped trays. And I actually thought, I was like, it's really cute all together, but I actually separated it. So I put all three jars in different rooms. And I really love them. They're really cute, like little catch-all trays. And I think they're like a statement, but also very like minimal. And I love them so much. These are from West Elm. I don't know if I mentioned that. And I'm obsessed. Okay, the next thing is a label maker, which I didn't bring the label maker up here, but I did bring a jar that I labeled. I bought it for my spice rack video, which I'll post in the description box if you guys want to go check it out. It is amazing and I'm still obsessed with it, but it's basically the label maker that does this type of lettering. I think it's super minimal, cool, and just a little like retro, like vintage vibe. So I did that, and I did a lotion and a mince, which I'm gonna put in my guest room in this little tray and put a little like chapstick with it just to set up the nightstand. And I think it's super cute, something for the people that stay at my house. And yeah, I think it's super fun. So I wanted to talk about the label maker just because I'm having clearly way too much fun with it, going overboard and labeling literally everything in my house. Okay, the next thing is this little glass vase. I got this at West Elm and I love how simple it is. You can just basically put like a little sprig of anything in it. A little greenery would even be cute, and I think it's just really pretty. And yeah, I love this. I think this was like $9 or something, not very expensive, but I just think it's so pretty. Love how simple it is. Yeah. Okay, the next little vase that I got from West Elm is this one. It looks like a little egg, kind of, but I just love how simple it is, and I love how narrow it comes at the top of it. I just think it's like really cool, and yeah, wanted to share that with you guys. Again, West Elm. If you can't tell, I'm a little West Elm crazy right now. Okay, the next thing that I got from West Elm are a couple of these big bowl type plates. We would make big salads or pasta, and we'd always wish we had like bigger bowls or bigger plates with like higher sides so that like the sauce won't go over. If you're like stirring a salad, like your salad doesn't fly off your plate and stuff. So I found these. They're really big. I mean, you can tell the size of my head. And yeah, we really like them. They're probably like 3 inches deep, so they have like a really nice lip on them. And I think even in the fall we'll use them for soup and stuff. So yeah, I bought a couple of these. I didn't buy a ton, but just enough for us to both have when we're having dinner. And yeah, I'm just really excited about these. I think they were like $10. The last home stuff that I want to show you guys are books. I've been loving, honestly, flipping through books this summer and also styling with them. I think they're just like super pretty and just fun to have out for people to like look through. So yeah, I bought this Dining In cookbook from Amazon. It was at Urban Outfitters as well, but I found it on Amazon for a lot cheaper. And I actually brought this to bed one night and was just like reading through it. And the author, or the chef, I guess, that wrote this book is so funny. So it was almost like I was reading a book and not a recipe book. So yeah, I really like it. I love what it looks like. It's super simple and modern, and I'm just gonna stack this with my other cookbooks in my kitchen. Love this one. The next book that I got is Urban Potters, which I thought it was really pretty. And again, just to put on a table, I thought it was cute. It also has like amazing photography, which I am obsessed with. I also took a pottery class in college and I really, really liked it. So I got this book. I thought it was kind of fun to look through and had a lot of pictures and like really pretty photography. So I bought that. Again, thought it would be really cute on a table, but also I loved looking through that. Last book that I bought was this You're Invited book. I actually got this a couple months ago and I found it at TJ Maxx, but when I saw it, I got so excited because I'm a graphic designer and it is basically an invitation book. So it's just like wedding invitations, party invites, and amazing photography, and I just was like so interested in like looking through it. I put this on the coffee table because I feel like anybody would like to look through this, and it's really pretty. I love the colors of it. And yeah, like I said, I got this at TJ Maxx and it was originally $60 and I think I got it for around 20 or something. So that was amazing. And it's just like my favorite book right now. Okay, and that is it for this video. If you guys liked anything throughout the video, check the description box. I will post it all or everything that I can find in the description. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.